Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to walk you through the steps on how to connect your FLIR camera to your network. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep up with all the latest videos like this one. And if you don't want to miss one, click on the bell icon to get notifications of all the new videos on our channel. Okay, let's get started. Topics covered in this video will include finding the computer's subnet, how to locate the camera's IP address, how to change the camera's IP address, and optionally, how to change your computer's IP address. To complete this process, you will need the following: a FLIR camera that is properly powered and connected to the correct network, a working computer that is also connected to the same network, FLIR IP config software, link to download will be in the description, and a web browser. Please note, if you're having trouble turning on the device, refer to the previous video for instructions on proper power-up. With all these components in place, we can now begin finding the computer's subnet. For devices to talk to each other in the same network, they must be within the same subnet. The subnet can be determined by using the command prompt application on Windows and entering the command ipconfig. A subnet is a way to divide a big network into smaller ones. The subnet mask is a code that helps identify which part of the IP address belongs to the network and which part belongs to the device. In this example, the subnet mask is 255.255.255.0, which means that the first three set of numbers of the IP address, 192.168.10, is the network address known as the subnet. Any numbers after that are not important. Finding the camera's IP address. By default, most devices use a dynamic IP address known as DHCP mode and will automatically search for the correct IP address in the subnet to establish communications with the connected computer. The FLIR IP config tool will list all compatible cameras on the subnet. Alternatively, you can use the free advanced IP scanner tool to determine the camera's IP address. To determine the IP address of your camera using the advanced IP scanner tool, first, download and run the advanced scanner tool. Click on the scan icon to list all devices on the subnet. Sort the list by clicking on the manufacturer tab and scroll to the devices with FLIR systems as the manufacturer. The IP address of the camera will be displayed, which you can use to log in to the web interface of the camera. Changing the camera's IP address. To set a static IP address for your camera using the FLIR IP config tool, first click on the desired camera, then click on the gear icon to access the camera's IP settings. In the dialog box that opens, select Use the following IP address and enter the IP address in the box. When setting a static IP address, please be mindful of the subnet. Set the subnet mask to the same value as the one found for your computer. Enter your network gateway address, or use an arbitrary IP address if you don't know your network gateway. The default gateway cannot be completely blank. Changing the computer's IP address. Please note, these steps are specific to Windows 10. Changing the IP address on other operating systems may differ. To change the IP address on your PC, first open View Network Connections and right-click on the Ethernet adapter. Select Properties and right-click on Internet Protocol Version 4 TCP/IP and click on Properties. Click on Use the following IP address option and type in your desired IP address. Please note, it is important to set the static IP address to an address that is not already taken. Your computer and FLIR camera must be on the same subnet or they will not be able to communicate with one another. Camera's web interface. To access the camera's web interface, type in the camera's IP address directly into the web browser. Use the provided login credentials to log into your camera's web interface. This concludes our video on how to connect your FLIR camera to your network. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep up with all our latest videos. And if you have any questions or need assistance, please email us at info@movitherm.com. As always, we want to thank you for choosing Movitherm. Until next time.